Dear students, today we shall study the poem Amanda, and the poetess is Robin Klein. You know that Robin Klein is an Australian poet born on 28 February 1936. She is still alive and writes especially for children. She is still alive and writes especially for children. In this poem, she points about important facts of a child's life. What does a child want? Amanda is a symbol of a child who feels that her freedom is curtailed, her freedom is reduced. By her parents. In this way, the child is quite unhappy with the continuous nagging of parents. Actually, what happens that a teenager doesn't want instructions and interference by the parents. A teenager feels that he or she is right and his or her parents are outdated and unnecessarily the parents interfere in his or her life. That's why a child is fed up with the continuous nagging of parents. What do you mean by nagging? To find fault. I want to recall you one poem that you have read in class 7. The poem's name was Chibi and the poet was Michael Rosen. And when Michael's parents take him to the school for admission, and the principal says in the interview, "What's your name?" And the young Michael says, "Michael Don't." When the principal asked him, "What's your name?" and the student says that, "My name is Michael Don't." Because his parents always tell him, "Michael, don't. Michael, don't do this thing. Don't do that thing." So he was always instructed not to do one thing or another. So the child feels that, "My name is Michael Don't." Okay. So he was quite unhappy. Now see the first stanza. "Don't bite your nails, Amanda. Don't hunch your shoulders, Amanda. Stop that slouching. And sit up straight, Amanda." This is the first statement. Don't bite your nails, Amanda. Don't hunch your shoulders, Amanda. Stop that slouching and sit up straight, Amanda. This was the instruction. So, Amanda is a girl or boy? Obviously, the name suggests that Amanda is a girl. So, who is giving the instruction, mother or father? Mother is giving instruction because a mother wants that her daughter should be perfect in every way. That's why she does the work to make her daughter perfect. As the gardener does the work of weeding, the gardener takes out the unwanted plants to make the other plants healthy. So this is the same work done by the mother. So she thinks that her daughter should be perfect in every way. Don't cut your nails, Amanda. This is very unhygienic. If you bite your nails, if you cut your nails, then you may fall ill. The dirt will go into your mouth and then in stomach. Don't hunch your shoulders, Amanda. Don't bend your shoulders, Amanda. Apne nakhun mat kato. This is a style of some students these days. Stop that slouching. What do you mean by slouching? Slouching means hanging down of head. Don't hang down your head, Amanda. And sit up straight. Come up straight, Amanda. There is a shower of instructions given by the mother to the daughter. Instructions ki bauchha. Shower of instructions. She says that if you cut your nails, then you may fall ill. This is very unhygienic. If you bend your shoulders, then you will grow hump on your back as you find on the back of a camel and you always hang down your head. These days, this is the style of a child. A child bends his shoulder and then hangs down his head. This is very bad. Bad posture. So this was the instruction. Now, we see the rhyme scheme. Literary device. Poetic device. First, rhyme scheme. A, different sound, B and A. A, B, A. Second, poetic device, alliteration. Repetition of same consonant sound at the beginning of words. S, 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 S. Okay. Now third poetic device. What do you find? Anaphora. What do you mean by anaphora? When a word or a group of words is repeated in two or more than two consecutive lines. दो या दो लगातार लाइन में कोई वर्ड या ग्रुप ऑफ वर्ड इज रिपीटेड, दिस इज कॉल्ड इन द बिगिनिंग ऑफ लाइन्स, दिस इज कॉल्ड एनाफोरा. एंड फोर्थ पोएट्री डिवाइस इज व्हाट? रिपीटिशन. In the last of the line, we find the same word repeated, Amanda, Amanda, Amanda. So, repetition is used to emphasize the idea, situation. Amanda is always instructed by her mother. So, we find what repetition here, poetic device. Now see here, the second stanza is given within bracket and this is called parenthesis. Parenthesis is given within bracket as an explanatorily remark. Child is fed up. She becomes unhappy. That's why she gives a silent reaction. She doesn't give open reaction because she has the fear that if she gives an open reaction, her mother may slap on her cheeks, on her soft cheeks. That's why she is giving silent reaction. And this style of poem is called what? Parenthesis. Now she is daydreaming. Amanda is daydreaming. Deen mein hi sapna dekh rahi hai. She is absorbed in her thought. She is thinking that if there is a language, languid means relaxed, peaceful, soul means only inhabitant means resident, Nivasi, who inhabits anywhere. Suppose that I inhabit in Bhagalpur. I am inhabitant of Bhagalpur. You reside in Bhagalpur. You are resident of Bhagalpur. Inhabitant means resident. Mermaid. A sea creature. Whose upper part is that of a woman and lower part of a fish. In Hindi, you can say what? Matasya Kanya, who swims in the water, in the sea. So, Amanda is thinking that if she finds a languid, relaxed, peaceful, comfortable green sea, काश उसे मिलता एक हरा समंदर मिलता. वेयर द सोल इनहेबिटेंट इज मी ओनली रेजिडेंट विल बी माई ओनली मी नॉट अदर देन मी केवल मैं ही वहाँ पर रहती. इन द फॉर्म ऑफ ए मर्मेड हु विल बी ड्रिफ्टिंग वो मूविंग करती ब्लिसफुली जॉयफुली. ड्रिफ्टिंग मीन्स मूविंग एंड ब्लिसफुली मीन्स जॉयफुली. काश मैं ग्रीन सी में, पीसफुल ग्रीन सी में मैं अकेले ही रहती. इन द फॉर्म ऑफ ए मर्मेड हु वुड बी ड्रिफ्टिंग जॉयफुली. नो वन शुड बी देयर टू डिस्टर्ब माय फ्रीडम. दिस इज द इमेजिनेशन ऑफ दैट गर्ल अमेंडा. शी वॉज डे ड्रीमिंग एंड दिस वॉज द साइलेंट रिएक्शन बाय द चाइल्ड. Mermaid. Okay, here we find the poetic device. Rhyme scheme. Because this is given within bracket, so it will be counted as C, me, C. Blissfully see. See me blissfully. Okay. If it had not been within bracket, then once again A or according to the sound. But this is within bracket. So the next rhyme scheme C C C. Now the second poetic device is what? Allusion. What do you mean by illusion? Reference to a very particular place, name or thing. Here, the poetess Robin Klein is referring to a mermaid, popular sea creature. Reference to a very popular person, particular person, thing or place. Okay, so this is allusion. And third poetic device is metaphor. Similarity between two things without using as or like. So here what is similarity? The greenness of sea, hariyali. Greenness of sea is compared to the greenness of stone. Emerald is what? Stone. In Hindi we can say panna. पन्ना आपने सुना होगा, देखा होगा, इसका रंग क्या होता है? हरा होता है. तो पन्ना पत्थर की हरियाली इज कंपेयर टू द ग्रीननेस ऑफ सी, टू द वाटर ऑफ सी. सो दिस इज मेटाफर. ओके, and now the third stanza. She was daydreaming when she gets a shower of instructions. Amanda starts daydreaming that there is a languid emerald sea. When she was absorbed in her own thought, अगेन देर इज सावर ऑफ instructions. फिर से instructions की बौछार होती है, सावर. दिस टाइम डिड यू फिनिश योर होमवर्क अमेंडा? डिड यू टाइडी योर रूम अमेंडा? आई थॉट आई टोल्ड यू टू क्लीन योर शूज अमेंडा. अगेन सावर ऑफ instructions. एंड यू नो दैट वेन पेरेंट्स bring any problem to the child, they feel that, parents feel that, if they want to make the child under control, so they should raise the question of study. Did you complete your study? पढ़ने लिखने का काम नहीं है. So here again the stress on the point of study. Did you finish your homework, Amanda? Always playing here and there, watching the TV serial, playing on the mobile. Did you finish your homework? Did you tidy? Tidy means arrange or neaten. I think you find the word, this word, neaten, new word. But this is not new word, familiar word. मैंने कई बार आपको कहा है कि adjective को हम verb बना सकते हैं en लगा करके. Weak से हो गया weaken, कमजोर कर देना. Hard adjective है harden. Strength adjective है strengthen. Neat means साफ. Adjective निटेन, साफ करना. डिड यू फिनिश योर होमवर्क अमेंडा? डिड यू अरेंज योर रूम अमेंडा? डिड यू निटेन योर रूम अमेंडा? आई थॉट आई टोल्ड यू टू क्लीन योर शूज अमेंडा. ऑलवेज आई हैव टू क्लीन योर शूज. व्हाट? यू विल गो टू स्कूल एंड यू योर सेल्फ शुड डू योर ड्यूटी. व्हाई शुड आई क्लीन योर शूज? So, but you have not cleaned your shoes also. Again, shower of instructions. Now, poetic device. this is not given within bracket. So here A. Second assonance. Repetition of same vowel or repetition of same vowel sound. You can say identical vowel. Identical vowel means जो एकदम बिल्कुल likeness हो, not difference. Where in the sound of vowel is prominent throughout the line. You see here. So this is assonance. And third thing we find here, anaphora also. What? Repetition of a word or a group of word in two or more than two consecutive lines. लगातार यहाँ पर did का use हुआ है. First line में, second line also did. And fourth, weighted device we find here repetition. Last word is Amanda. Do you feel also happy where your parents nag at you? Find fault with you. Nag मतलब गलती ढूंढना, लेकिन nag के बाद preposition at लगेगा, और find के बाद with लगेगा. Do you feel happy when your parents nag at you? Do you feel happy when your parents find fault with you? I think that you must have understood the meaning and poetic devices of three stanzas. Now, next day. Okay, thank you.